had a lot of intervention into my antenatal care due to my mental health problems. But in terms of postnatal care, there was very little out there in terms of having a baby, like, and what that might affect your mental health and coping. It felt like a lot of the support just drifted away. So I still had my mental health appointments, but any specialist care kind of stops when you have a baby. And I think I was quite shocked at how I'd gone from really kind of, well, it wasn't always there, the antenatal care, but eventually it was when I got to see a consultant obstetrician and she knew something was wrong. And she actually got me the help that I needed, and this was antenatally. And so thanks to her that she pretty much saved my life. As I had really bad episodes, but then suddenly all this care is taken away once you have a baby. It's like in the run up to the birth, I had so many extra appointments, but it was weird, they were just checking my physical health rather than my mental health, even though that's why I was high risk, was because of my mental health. But other than this consultant, everyone seemed too scared and too fearful that if they asked and something was wrong, then it would kind of be on their head to check it out. So it was like, oh, you look like you're doing okay, oh, you're doing really well, you look glowing and whatnot. So there was very little room to say, actually, I'm suicidal, or I'm really struggling with this pregnancy and I don't know what I'm going to do. It was all niceties rather than kind of proper care. So I was very lucky the second pregnancy to get this obstetrician, who I could only see kind of occasionally, but at least it meant that I got some form of care, because she wasn't too scared to ask the difficult questions, and she wasn't just doing me on one of those "are you going to kill yourself" sheets. She just genuinely cared.
Do you, I mean, without any boundaries or barriers?
So, I think for me, during the pregnancy, the pros in terms of care was obviously this consultant, but the cons were the second time round, the midwives just did not ever give you any time to say if you were struggling mentally, and you felt like they were always in a rush, which they probably were. So yeah, I guess that I struggled with, because I had loads of questions and whatnot because of medication and pregnancy. But I got a lot of that anyway.
Help eventually from the mental health team. So that was another pro, but it took me to get to a crisis point before I got that intervention, and then suddenly I got kind of 24/7 care. It would have been better to have some preventative measures
rather than letting me get like suicidal where I need to miss B section. But luckily I had my husband to kind of care for me then. And I guess it would also be good if you, as a parent, had a chance
to say what kind of care you wanted. So I had so many scans and whatnot just because I was measuring small.
And it just seemed a bit silly when actually the main problem was my mental health, not my physical health. So yeah, I guess if somebody had just asked me and gave me examples of care that might work for me, personal care, that would have really helped, because I like
to be very practical, and I don't always want to bring up the past, and
especially when you're so emotional as a kind of pregnant mom. So yeah, I guess giving women the control over their care in every sense when it comes to pregnancy and childbirth and aftercare. It's all about control, isn't it? And I think too often we try and take control away from people, and then we all get in a tricky dilemma. So, aftercare.
I think the pros were the fact that I still had the mental health team involved, because they had to be involved.
I think it was like a year after childbirth, and I was lucky because where I live, there's some great charities like Home Start
and like the
breastfeeding, the Little Angels, and also a place called Fab. So they help with your breastfeeding, and they drop you text, the 24/7 helpline.
That was really good, and Home Start were really, really good. But they're charities,
so that's not.
And they've had a lot of funding cuts, so not everyone gets that. So that was definitely the pros in my care. But yeah, then the cons, I guess, there's just not a lot of
kind of help. So, you know, even physically, not just mentally, actually,
after childbirth. You know, if you've got a prolapse,
not just a relapse in mental health,
like what you do with
your pelvic floor muscles, it's kind of like you've got a baby now, get on with it.
And yeah, your body does massively change when you
have a baby, and if you decide to breastfeed and whatnot. So just to have a conversation about those things, because it can be quite a difficult time. You're very sensitive.
Your identity is all over the place, and also your body and mind is. So yeah, I think
it needs to be like a real focus, the aftercare, because obviously, as well as they
say, it's like the NCT charity, it's all about like
your first days of parenting, because that massively affects your baby, your children, your family. So it makes sense, rather than beginning with issues, to actually help people at the start. And then, I guess, for me, the challenges was there wasn't a lot of care like that I could have in terms of my mental health with also having kids. So I wouldn't want to leave like a newborn baby. And like, I had been offered to go to a mother and baby unit, but I had an older daughter as well. So that was a massive challenge, what to do. Because obviously I would be in even worse a mess if I couldn't see my kids. And yeah, so like I say, better help for your mental health with breastfeeding, because it shouldn't be just potluck. And also in terms of your physical health. One change I'd like to see when it comes to postnatal care
is
that there's better care
for the mothers, because
a lot of the time it's all kind of baby focused
once you have the baby, and yes, that obviously is right as well. But in terms of the mother's
physical and mental health,
yeah,
you get your 6-week checkup. But it's kind of more of a tick box, and there's
not an awful lot of time, you know, if you're having real issues. So yeah, I would like to see better care for mums. So when health visitors come round, they're checking on you and baby, and putting in the right support for you
and your family,
which involves often the dad as well. They need support too.
Please share this video for Mumsnet's campaign for better postnatal
care. For aftercare, not afterthought.